Welcome to Omega Open Course. In this video, we will learn about the radius of curvature and how to calculate it for any given curve. We will not be using the mathematical definition of radius of curvature, but approach it through simple concepts of physics. This does not mean it cannot be used to calculate radius of curvature of mathematical curves. With this method, you can calculate the radius of curvature of any curve that you encounter at IIT JEE level. Let us take any curved path. Each small segment of this curve can be considered to be a part of a circle. The center of this circle is called the center of curvature of the curve at that point, and the radius of the circle is called the radius of curvature of the curve at that point. Physically, more the path is curved at any point, lesser is its radius of curvature at that point. To calculate the radius of curvature of a curve at a point, let us consider a particle moving on the curve. Let us assume that at the instant when it reaches the point, its instantaneous velocity is v. The direction of this velocity is always along the tangent to the curve. The particle can have two different accelerations. If its speed is changing, then it will have a tangential acceleration whose direction is along the velocity or along the tangent to the curve at the point. The magnitude of this acceleration is given by rate of change of speed, or mathematically it is derivative of speed with respect to time. The speed may be represented by the magnitude of the velocity vector. If the particle is moving with a uniform speed, then this tangential acceleration is zero. On a curved path, the particle will always have a centripetal or radial acceleration, which is always directed towards the center of curvature of the path at that point. The magnitude of this acceleration, as you already know, is v square by r, where v is the instantaneous speed of the particle and r is the radius of curvature at that point. The net acceleration of the particle is vector sum of these two accelerations, which is mathematically equal to the derivative of velocity vector with respect to time. Now, in order to find the radius of curvature of any path at any given point, we need to define a motion of a particle that travels on the path. If we can find the instantaneous velocity and acceleration of the particle, using the above relations, we can always calculate its radius of curvature. Radial acceleration is the square of instantaneous speed divided by radius of curvature, which implies radius of curvature is the square of instantaneous speed divided by radial acceleration. So if we know instantaneous velocity and radial acceleration, we can calculate radius of curvature. If we know the velocity vector and acceleration vector of the particle at given point, then also its radius of curvature can be calculated. Since net acceleration of the particle is resultant of its radial and tangential accelerations, the component of net acceleration along velocity vector is tangential acceleration of the particle, and component perpendicular to the velocity vector is radial acceleration. Therefore, if theta be the angle between velocity vector and acceleration vector, radial acceleration is net acceleration into sine theta. Thus, radius of curvature in this case is v square divided by net acceleration into sine theta. Following examples will show how to use this concept in problem solving. Example 1. Find the radius of curvature at the vertex of a parabola given by equation y square is equal to 4 alpha x. Let us assign a motion to a particle that moves along this parabola. Let us assume its y coordinate varies with time as y is equal to vt. Since for the parabola y square is equal to 4 alpha x, x is equal to y square divided by 4 alpha. Putting the value of y, we get x is equal to v square t square divided by 4 alpha. Please note that there is nothing special about assigning y is equal to vt. You could have assigned y is equal to root vt or v into t cube. Or you could have simply assigned x is equal to vt and have calculated the value of y from there. The radius of curvature is property of the curve, not the motion. So the radius of curvature at any point on the curve will be same irrespective of the nature of motion or velocity of the particle. So we could have assigned any value to y or x as long as x and y satisfy the equation of the curve. Thus the position vector of the particle with time is given by v square t square by 4 alpha I cap plus vt j cap. Differentiating the position vector with respect to time, we get velocity vector is equal to v square t by 2 alpha I cap plus v j cap. Differentiating with respect to time once again, we get acceleration vector is equal to v square by 2 alpha I cap. We have to find the radius of curvature at the vertex, that is 0, 0 coordinate. The value of parameter t is 0 at this position. So we can get the velocity vector of the particle at vertex by putting t is equal to 0 in the expression. This gives velocity vector is equal to vj cap, Also, the acceleration independent of time is v square by 2 alpha I cap. You may have noticed the velocity at the vertex is along y-axis and acceleration is along x-axis. This means acceleration is perpendicular to the velocity or acceleration is radial acceleration. Now the radius of curvature is square of speed divided by the radial acceleration. Putting the values, we get r is equal to v square divided by v square by 2 alpha. Simplifying, we get r is equal to 2 alpha. This is our answer. Let us consider another example. Suppose that in the same parabola, we have to find the radius of curvature at a point whose coordinate is alpha, 2 alpha. Since we have defined the y coordinate of the particle moving on this curve as y is equal to vt and y coordinate at given point is 2 alpha, the value of t for this point is 2 alpha by v. As we have calculated in the last example, the velocity vector of the particle is v square t by 2 alpha I cap plus vj cap. Putting the value of t, we get velocity vector is equal to vi cap plus vj cap. The square of magnitude of velocity at this point is v square plus v square or 2v square. Acceleration at this point 2 is v square by 2 alpha I cap. We can use dot product to find the angle between the velocity vector and acceleration vector. If theta be this angle, then cos theta is given by dot product of velocity vector and acceleration vector divided by product of magnitudes of velocity and acceleration. Putting the values, we get cos theta is equal to v cube by 2 alpha divided by root 2v into v square by 2 alpha. Simplifying, we get cos theta is equal to 1 by root 2 or theta is equal to pi by 4. Now the radius of curvature is given by the square of speed divided by radial acceleration. The square of speed at the point is 2v square and since the angle between the velocity vector and acceleration vector is theta, the radial acceleration is acceleration into sine theta. Putting the values, we get r is equal to 2v square divided by v square by 2 alpha into 1 by root 2. Simplifying, we get radius of curvature at this point is equal to 4 root 2 alpha. This is our answer. Given on the screen are some of the questions where this concept has been used to find the radius of curvature. Watching those videos will help you understand this concept better. If you want us to discuss some concept or theory, you can request it by posting it in comments below. If you found this video useful, like and share the video to help other students find us. Subscribe the channel, like our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter for latest updates. Thank you for watching.